We have exclusive video tonight of some of Sydney's most dangerous drivers, motorists who can't manage the Harbour Tunnel. And they have authorities very concerned.
10's Andrew Denny joins us now from North Sydney. Andrew, these pictures are quite incredible. You really have uncovered some shocking incidents here.
Well, Deb, shocking may even be an understatement. What you're about to see is some of Sydney's most dangerous and idiotic drivers caught on camera. Every piece of security vision was filmed along this 2-kilometre stretch of road behind me. It's what Sydney Harbour Tunnel operators have to deal with every day. And police say it's only a matter of luck that many of the people involved weren't killed.
Moments of inattention with serious consequences. These are the videos that have authorities shaking their heads.
We're living with these people, we're driving with these people, and the damage is done to too many people when they kill someone else or kill themselves.
Watch as a truck driver chops two lanes and hits a car from behind. The rig jackknifes and veers into oncoming traffic.
At this stage of my career, nothing surprises me. On the road, motorists do many, many silly things.
It's not just truckies at fault. Intoxicated pedestrians have tried to brave Sydney's highways. Watch here as he falls 3 metres onto concrete, missing a speeding car by centimetres. The sheer stupidity of some drivers is dangerous, like this man who, in a fit of road rage, pulled over to abuse a driver behind him, but forgot to put on his handbrake. He runs to chase his car, but it rolls away with no one at the wheel. For 500 metres, it bounces off the walls.
This is what we're putting up with. Weekly, monthly, whichever.
Many of these videos capture crashes caused by inexperience, like this rider towing an advertising trailer. But they also catch behaviour beyond belief. This woman accidentally entered an e-toll lane. Instead of paying later, she tries to rip out the lane dividers to cross over.
The mistake they make, or the mistake the driver in front makes, could turn their life upside down.
Well, believe it or not, these are only some of the incredible images that we've obtained of carnage in the tunnel. Join us at 6 o'clock for more.
Thank you, Andrew Denny. And more now in our exclusive story on the behaviour of drivers on our roads, behaviour that has authorities worried.
10's Andrew Denny joins us once again from North Sydney. Andrew, we saw that incredible vision earlier. There are a lot of incidents that are happening in this area.
Yeah, there are, and unfortunately for all of us who use the roads, I have more of this vision. If you've only just joined us, we've been showing you exclusive pictures from the Sydney Harbour Tunnel of some of the carnage that happens on our roads. I might show you some more now if I could. In this first piece of vision, you'll see the driver of a small hatchback merge in front of a truck. Now watch closely as that truck then continues to tailgate behind her, accelerating to the point where he's actually pushing the vehicle along. Now this continues for a few hundred metres until the car swerves off the side and hits the side of the tunnel. And if that's not bad enough, watch now as other drivers don't get out to help. They simply continue, they swerve around and continue around her. Now in this next piece of vision, which was only filmed a few days ago, you'll see a tyre come off the side of a trailer. Now that tyre then bounces down along the tunnel. Other drivers are forced to swerve to miss it. The people towing this trailer were actually pulling along a ride-on mower, and with their trailer not working, they unload it and then actually proceed to drive it out of the tunnel. Now, authorities say dealing with behaviour and driving like this is extremely difficult.
And what we're asking guys to do is manage an incident that they've got no idea is going to occur.
But the fact is that you can't engender common sense through road rules, and common sense needs to be displayed by drivers more importantly than anything else.
So that's the message police want to get out there now. A bit of common sense and safe driving will certainly go a long way.
Thank you. Andrew Denny with that report.